are one in unaligned mission and vision, instilling excellence in electrical profession, having a dynamic profession.
Hello, everyone. Good day. Once again, this is Professor Roger Flores of the Department of Electrical Engineering of Central Mindanao University, your professor of the subject EA73, the basic occupational safety and health. Okay, for today, we are going to continue our discussion for this chapter 4. This is entitled Ergonomics. Okay, this chapter will discuss the comfortability of our worker in the field. This is where you're going to interface the power or the employee, our labor, our subordinates to the machine or any equipment in the field. Okay, so that this employee might not experience more stresses or more stress in performing his duty and responsibility. Okay, so to start discussing this chapter 4, ergonomics, then we will have this chapter 4, okay? This is ergonomics now. The question here is, what is ergonomics? Okay, so that is the basic question that maybe some of us heard or knew this word by just today, no? So what is this ergonomics all about, and how it affects to the performance of our employee or our labor, our operations, no? Especially for those assigned to operate a machine or any other equipment or facilities. This ergonomics is from two Greek words. Okay, first is ergon. So what is meant by ergon? This is ergon means work. Okay, so meaning this is related to work. No, ergonomics is in relation to work. That is why I said a while ago that there is what we call as interfacing of equipment, facilities, and other material, no? Other material interfaced with it with the operator or our employee. Another word is nomoi, so meaning natural law. So when we say natural law, that is, of course, the existence of this thing is in a form of a natural existence, no? So this means that this is the science of work and a person's relationship to that work. Okay, so science and science of work and a person's who will operate that thing or equipment, no? In relation to the work that is for that purpose, no? So it is the scientific discipline concerned with understanding of interactions, that is what I've said, interfacing among humans and other elements of a system. When we say a system, it is composed of several subsystems, no? Part or a process in the to produce an output of a certain organization or activity, no? And the profession that applies theory, principles, and data and method to design in order to optimize human well-being and overall system performances or performance. Okay, so that is the interaction, no? It is a discipline that interacts with the performance of a certain human, or in other words, our employee, to do or to perform its activity, no? And overall, in the overall system of performance. Now, the person that practice the ergonomics is called ergonomist. Okay, so ergonomist, that is the person or a human that practice ergonomics. Okay, next question is, why is ergonomics important? Okay, bakit po ba importante ito ergonomics in a certain workplace? Okay, so accordingly, this is to minimize chronic physical injuries. Okay, and yun po bang grabe na ano, mga injuries or stresses that might a person or a labor or a subordinate experience in the workplace. And psychological stresses, no? While maximizing the productivity and efficiency of a person. Okay, so while doing this job, while doing performing this given tasks, so to minimize this psychological stresses, mahirap ito pag mayroon tayong problema psychologically. It's very hard for our labor, our subordinates to perform efficient or effective, effectively or efficiently, if there is what we call a psychological stresses that affects the well-being of this person. Okay, so in maximizing the productivity and efficiency of this person assigned to that job, it is our responsibility, being a manager or in the administration, to minimize all these injuries, physical injuries, chronic physical injuries, and psychological stresses towards our people in the field or in the workplaces, no? So we have to minimize all these things. That is why we have to try to implement this, what we call as ergonomics. Okay, so we have this, before we will continue, we have this trivia, no? That 1/3 of all absences in each year is caused by injuries, and these injuries cost business $1 billion in workers' compensation each year. Okay, so this is the world record, and experiences, and as observed by businesses and any other workplaces or companies, no? That accordingly, 1/3 of all these absences of the employee caused by injury, okay, and other that will result to losses or lose of the company, no? Billion, okay. So, and maybe compensation, okay, yung ginasta natin para lang sa mga empleyado natin due to this injury. Okay, so bakit po ba maka-injured? So siguro they were not comfortable. Okay, hindi yung match yung situation at saka yung tao. Okay, so that is our trivia. The application of ergonomics in working situations. So ano po ba yung mga application? Okay, so next, the application of ergonomics in working situations. So pag sinabi nating working situations dito, it refers to the workplaces. Okay, so paano ba natin i-apply itong principle ng ergonomics dito sa mga workstations, mga workplaces natin? Okay, so this ergonomics covers 4 physical areas. Unang-una po dito sa tinatawag natin na human system. So because most of our workplaces, siguro dito sa Pilipinas, manned by of course a human being, no? Hindi lahat, o hindi pa masyadong gumamit tayo ng robotic system dito sa Pilipinas. Kaya nga ang mga operator natin or mga workers natin are still human. Okay, So that is one of the principal areas that we are going to consider ergonomics. Another one is working environment. Working environment is another areas to be considered when it comes to ergonomics, no? The workplace, the flow of the operations, okay? The arrangement, or even the operator that we need to assign in that specific place, no? In that specific operation. So we have also this number three. We have this man-machine interface. Okay, so interfacing yung operator tsaka yung makina. Paano ba natin sila interface? Or how the operator, meaning how the operator will operate this machine. So, walang problema doon sa makina, kasi yung makina, pag ano yung function niya, yun talaga yung function niya. Kung walang tao dyan, hindi yan magpo-function. Pero yung tao dapat we should have to consider ergonomics and comfortability of that person while doing his or her job, no? So man and machine interfacing. Then we have this number four area. Okay, principal area is the total working system. The whole system, okay? So how this will affect to the whole system or the whole operation of the organization or of our company or industry, the process, no? So that is why we have to consider total working system as one of the areas of consideration. Okay, so let's start with this human system. This area is concerned with people, okay, so mga tao po ito. In particular, the physical aspects such as stamina, strength, and body dimensions. Okay, kailangan po natin ito eh. Pag yung makina natin, yung equipment natin, kailangan ng medyo malalaking tao or maliliit na tao. So we need to have the body dimensions and its strength. Okay, so siguro pag yung makina natin, yung equipment natin, mas maganda kung babae ang mag-ooperate. So lagyan natin ng babae. Kung kailangan natin ng medyo strong operations, so we need to have siguro yung lalaki yung i-operate natin. So ganyan, kailangan natin ng physical aspect, no? And also the stamina, baka madali lang ma-stress. So kailangan natin ng higher strength for this certain machine or any operation in the system. Okay, and the psychological aspects also of human behavior. Behavior is very important also in the performance of any duties and job, no? Okay, or the tasks. Okay, kaya nga mayroong mga company natin na yung mga nagtatrabaho doon ay mga babae. Bakit po ba mga babae? Kasi sabi daw nila, psychologically, yung mga babae mataas yung pasyensya, no? Kasi mayroong mga trabaho, mayroon tayong mga, siguro mga, yung tinatawag natin na mga workers assembly line na kailangan ng medyo mahabang pasensya yung trabaho kasi delikado or ayun. So, that is why mga babae yung inilagay nila doon, no? So, ayun, kailangan po natin ng human behavior. Okay. Of course, psychological aspects also. And also perception, okay? Learning and reaction to given situation. Kasi po, mayroon tayong mga siguro mga workers na medyo mahina ng konti yung mga perceptions nila. How to perceive, how to understand. Okay? Okay, so kailangan, siguro mayroon tayong mga trabaho na kailangan yung mabilisan yung decision making. So kailangan natin ng mga ganun. So these are some of the aspects of a human behavior and the psychological aspects also that we are going to consider to let us being the operator or yan operator of the machine that we need to interface. Okay, so another, okay, so the working environment, siguro it is understood that in any working environment, yun po ang causes ng stress ng ating mga empleyado, no? So, can be serious effects on worker performance, of course. Typical environmental stressors are extremes of temperature. Okay, so another one, inadequate or badly designed lighting. Okay, so siguro hindi masyadong maliwanag yung trabaho. Stressor yan. Sakit yan sa mata or whatsoever, no? Temperature also, as we said, no? That is very important also because pag masyadong mainit, your body cannot resist all this high temperature. Madali lang ma-stress yung body natin. Kaya nga, we need to have a normal temperature as much as possible. Okay? So, inadequate ventilation, okay, in relation to the temperature also. So, ayan, high levels of humidity. Okay, so noise, ayan. Baka masyadong taas yung frequency ng sound. Okay, so if that will be the case, if of course, baro tayong mga trabaho na andyan talaga, kailangan talaga yung sitwasyon or situation that masyadong maingay. Kaya nga, pag ganon, so we have to study and minimize this noisiness, no? So, siguro, bigyan natin sila ng mga muffler, no? To minimize noise and to damage their air, no? So, vibrations also, dust, of course, fumes and any other or even radiation. So whatever, no, maka-affect physically and psychologically of this person who are assigned to this particular situation. Okay? So ito po yung tinatawag natin na working environment. So kailangan natin na we have to consider this thing so that the operator or the people that assigned to this system will have or will experience a normal situation to minimize stresses. Then we have this the man-machine interface. Ito na po. So machine manufacturers and designers frequently produce machinery which places the operator under considerable stresses or stress, either through the design and location of controls or badly designed display. Okay, so siguro doon nila makuha yung stress nila sa design. Ang hirap ng to understand this design, no? And it's very hard to follow the instruction of this design and even location of the controls. Okay, so this machine, so baka yung control niya ay nandoon sa taas, baka aakyatin pa, parang ganun. So it is not that might result to uncomfortability of the operator. Or, ayun, baka hindi maganda yung position niya, location, and unreadable display, for example, ng mga data na kailangan natin na kunin. So, ayun, it might result to stresses, no? Good standards of design of this man-machine interface take into account the design of controls. Yung sa control system natin, mga ganyan, display, yung sa arrangement natin, or even effects of automation and communication system. So, yun, when we say automation, that is the performance of any task using with the help of this machine. Okay, a system or operation of that machine. Okay, particularly in very large machine, no, with a view to reducing operator error. Okay, when talking about a display, no, so dapat ma-view, clearly viewed, no, so ma-view natin klaro yung mga display ng machine natin. So ibig sabihin, especially for the bigger or large machines, no, so yung operator that sometimes commit error because hindi niya masyadong mabasa yung display. Okay, so lalo na hindi masyadong maliwanag ang yung display. So it will cause to stresses, especially this operator might commit error because of this not so clear display and even arrangement of the control of that machine. Okay, so next is total working system. These factors or factors such as the potential for fatigue and stresses are considered at this stage, along with aspects such as we have as work rate and productivity. Okay, so this working system, total working system, might affect the stress and results to severe fatigue of our operator and worker, no? That of course we might reduce the productivity and the work rate of that operator. Okay, so specific health and safety is very important features are considered. Okay, in particular the effects of operator error. So ito po, it will affect this stress might affect the health of the operator, at the same time might affect the safety of these people who are working in this specific system. And the totality of this effect will results to the yun, magresulta po ito sa performance ng ating company. So it will might results to injuries, and this injury will results to yun, malugi yung or liliit yung production natin because dumami or mga injuries ng mga o problema ng mga empleyado natin. Okay, so principles of ergonomic design. Okay, so ito na po. Unang-una po is yung about sa principles on vision. Okay, so the operator should be able to set and read with ease controls. Okay, yun na mention natin kanina po, yung display. So dapat the operator be able to set and read easily, clearly our controls, no, and specific instruments and displays of instruments. Ayun. This prevents or reduces the fatigue and is so frequently the cause of faulty perception and accidents. Okay, so it's very clear, no, that because yan nga po, kahit hindi na masyadong klaro yung display ng makina natin, ginagamit pa rin natin, no? So, kasi baka masyadong matanda na yung makina, hindi na nakapag-display, kaya ang gagawin na lang ng mga operator natin, i-estimate na lang nila yung mga reading or mga data na kinakailangan nila. So, that might results to an erroneous result or erroneous output of the performance of these individuals. Okay, also this posture. Okay, abnormal working postures increase the potential for fatigue also, accidents and long-term injury. Okay, so halimbawa, yung position ng operator, nakaupo. O, paano ba yung suggested na paano ba makaupo? Kailangan yan, baka masira yung spine niya, yung spinal column. Baka iba na yung postura niya paglabas sa operation or sa yun, sa trabaho. So kailangan natin ng posture. that later on, siguro mamaya, mayroon tayong mga picture na ipapakita natin kung paano ba o ano po ba yung right position and posture or working position na gagawin, no, para we have to maintain good posture that may result to injury to our employee. Okay, so all work processes and systems of work should be designed to permit a comfortable posture. Okay, so kailangan natin yan, no? Lalo na yung trabaho is 8 hours or a continuous whole day operation, nandoon siya. Okay, so we need to have a comfortable position and posture to perform his tasks. Okay, and also layout. This is the next principle that you are going to consider. Okay, so in any working area, there should be free movement between operating positions. Okay, baka masyadong masikip yung working environment, no? So safe access and egress, no? And unhindered oral and visual communication. Okay, so kailangan po natin 'yan, no? Movement between operating positions. So 'yun, kailangan hindi masyadong masikip. We have a certain area that will be able to siguro para there might be some free movement within that area. 'Yun. Kasi pag hindi tayo makapag 'yun, makapag-exercise ng konti kasi masyadong masikip yung area natin, so it's very hard na 'yun, it will affect our posture, it will affect our body movement, no? Safe access and egress. Okay. So we have some yung safety ayun, space for exits, entrance, and any other exits, mga exits, no, mga accesses, no, and unhindered oral and visual communication. So when we say oral communication, maraming example yan, yung mga communication na pwede yung through verbal communication. Kaya minsan mayroon po tayong tinatawag na visual communication lang, di ba? Yung mayroon tayong mga signal or mga sinyas sa Bisaya. So, we have this signal, no? So, body actions. Okay. Halimbawa, maraming ibig sabihin eh. Pag sinabi natin ganyan, so ano po bang ibig sabihin ng ganyan? So, siguro, kahit medyo maingay yung workplace natin, that siguro yung mga katrabaho natin will understand pag we have this sign, no? So ibig sabihin siguro approve. Okay, approve. Okay yan. Okay. So pag sinabing okay, the control system, for example, baka tinanong na, okay, kumusta yung performance ng makina natin? Yung temperature ng makina natin? Is it still in the range of the good temperature or desired temperature for the machine? Baka sinyas na tayo, okay. So, ibig sabihin, okay. So, yun po ang mga ganyan, no, na kailangan natin sa layout ng trabaho natin na hindi ito madidisturbo yung mga ganyan mga communication system. Okay, so oral, verbal, or even visual communication using this mga yung mga sign, mga signs, no, mga communication signs. Okay, so next, comfort. Okay, this is another principle that you are going to consider in our workplaces, no. Environmental factors have a direct effect on operator comfort, so that is very important. Yan pong sabi ko po kanina na dapat mayroon tayong tinatawag na comfortability. In particular, the levels of lighting and ventilation and the percentage relative humidity of the atmosphere. Okay. Kailangan na whatever the natural situation sa labas, kung pwede, yun din po yung adjustment natin sa loob para yung body temperature, yung adjustment ng body natin dyan sa labas, galing sa labas, pagpasok natin sa loob, ay as much as possible, parehas-parehas lang yun, no? Dapat. So, when it comes to ventilation and relative humidity. So, when it comes to lighting also, so, of course, para hindi masira yung mata ng mga empleyado natin, so, the intensity of light should be adjusted, no? So, kung halimbawa, sa operations, mayroon tayong mga tinatawag na mga display. Okay? So, kailangan na medyo maliwanag yon para at least klaro. Okay? So, those are some of factors or some of the principle that you are going to consider when it comes to comfortability or comfort. And then, we have this work rate. So, of course, when we say rate, this is with respect to time, no? So, gaano kabilis ang trabaho natin? Okay? Should be set to suit the operator. Hindi naman masyadong hindi natin gagawing robot yung operator natin. Okay? So, pag ang speed ng operator natin or ng mga tao is until this range, so, of course, the rate of work should be within this range. Na hindi naman siguro pwedeng for the whole day tatakbo yung tao kasi that is not his or her normal operation. Okay? But need constant reassessment and revision. Of course, pag yung operator natin is malakas yung katawan, strong, so ibig sabihin, pwede naman siguro natin lakas-lakasan ng konti yung work rate niya. Okay? Or we have to change the target or whatsoever. Kaya nga mayroon tayong constant reassessment, no? Okay, and revision also when it comes to work rate. Kung mayroon naman tayong trabaho na resulta is our employee, our laborer, our subordinates will results to idleness. Yung nakatambay lang. So siguro, we have to change and we have to reassess and revise the work rate of that certain situation or process. Na? Okay, so ito po yung sinabi ko po kanina. Yung mga position, actions, and the performance of a job which is proper and to protect the posture and the, of course, injury, against injury of this situation. Okay, so halimbawa, ganit dito po, okay, pag mayroon tayong mabubuhatin, so this is a wrong position or wrong way. Okay, ito po. So this is how you are going to lift or pagbubuhat ng isang mabibigat na bagay. So mali daw ito eh. Ito po yung tama, no? The right way. So hindi po tayo parabang this is not the right position. It will damage our waist, no? Ito po sa may ano, so sa waistline natin, yung connection ng mga bone natin galing sa taas from the upper limb going to this lower limb, no? So ito po mas yung part ng body natin yung masisira dito. Kaya nga ito po daw yung correct position. Okay, ito po daw yung correct position, the right way. So, ito, pinakita lang natin, parang robot, ito po yung correct position, correct lifting technique. Okay, so ito po yung incorrect dito po, incorrect po ito. Kasi pag ganito po yung position natin, ang mangyayari po dito, yung dito sa may baywang, ito po masisira yung mga, yung sa hip bone natin, no? Masisira dito. So, yan, that is one, of course, suggested way or the right way how to lift a certain yung mabibigat na bagay. Okay, so kahit sa plaster o posture ng hand natin, no? Especially if we are going to use ano po yung tawag, yung sa keyboard ng computer, working typing, encoding in the use of computers. So ito pong sa baba dito, mali daw ito eh. So it will damage our wrist. Dito po, madamage po ito. Okay, so siguro yung position ng pag-encode o pagta-type natin sa keyboard, ito po yung correct. That there must be a continuous or the straight position of your hands, your fingers, and your arms. Okay? So, ito po yung daw yung correct position. Ito po sa kabila, this is how you're going to, yung position ng elbow. No? So, yung elbow natin, so naka-straight or nakadikit dito sa may arm natin, no? Dito sa tagiliran. No? So, dapat naka-connect or nakadikit sa may tagiliran. Hindi masyadong malayo para it will not damage our elbow. So, keep your elbows close by your side or dito sa katawan mo. Okay? So, dito po sa baba, yan, this is the proper, no? Proper position of your arms. Okay? Dito sa braso. Especially if you are holding machines. Okay? Or reaching out or out for the mouse or keyboards of your computer. Okay, so ayan, unang-una nakadikit yan sa yung elbow nyo, nakadikit sa katawan, sa to your side. So it must be in the this position. Okay, so para hindi masyadong ma-injured yung shoulder natin, no? Dito sa shoulder. Okay, kasi pag malayo yung mouse natin, katulad dito, kasi po, ito po, parang ang manangyari dito is malayo yung mouse, malayo yung keyboard. So, this will be stretched out, no? So, ayun, it will maybe injured or damage or your shoulder. So, kaya nga, pagdating ng siguro, pag at the end of your shift, yung shift, work shift ninyo, pag end ng work shift, ay medyo lupay-pay na yung shoulder ninyo. So, this is some of the suggested position, especially if you are using computers. And then also, if you are operating a machine, so siguro, still, this is applicable. Pagtignan ninyo kung paano nakaupo yung tao dito, hindi pong nakayuko, no? Hindi po yung nakayuko na kwan. Kailangan na sit erect, yon ang sabi ng teachers natin noon. Sit erect. Kasi po it will protect our spinal, no? Or spines natin dito ng mga bones natin. So you should have to sit erect. Okay, so huwag kayong makayuko kasi the balance of our body will not be in the proper position. So, it will result to injury. Okay? So, this is another presentation or a picture of a computer encoder or working with the computer. So, kung tingnan niyo po dito, talking about sit erect, no? Or correct position or sitting. So, we should have to consider this one. Dapat sit erect. Tsaka your setback angle, no? Dapat yung sa likod mo dito ay naka-touch talaga sa ano, sa support ng body support ng upuan ninyo. Ayun, pagtitingnan dito sa likod, no? So we should have to use this kaya sinabi nila na computer chair. Okay? So, ngayon, yung mga kabataan ngayon, mayroon tayong sinasabi na gaming chair. Bakit sinasabi nilang gaming chair? Kasi ang tatagal yung tao, yung mga anak natin, tatagal yan sa laro. Hindi nila they cannot realize, so, siguro makalimutan nila yung oras sa paglalaro kasi excited sila doon sa laro. Nakalimutan nila na ilang oras na silang naglaro doon, Kaya mayroon tayong tinatawag na gaming chair. Siguro ito, kamukha dito. Kaya nga yung iba pa dito, mayroon pang hanggang dito sa ulo na ma-support dito hanggang ulo, no? So mayroon tayong mga gaming chair to support the body of the user of that chair. Okay. So dapat yung height ng chair natin, ganito po yun, no? So ito po yung seat height na yung mga paa natin, yung thigh natin dito should be leveled. Okay. So ganitong mangyayari, no? Dinagdagan niya dito ng siguro platform dito, baka baba na lahat yung adjustment natin dito sa upuan. Saka medyo pag medyo hindi masyadong mataas yung operator, so kailangan na ipatong natin itong paa natin dito sa platform para more or less level yung paa natin dito. Okay? So ganyan. So kahit hindi kahit ibang trabaho, no, really in relation, kahit hindi sa computer, pero kailangan natin ng ganito. So level yan, no, ng paa. So that ditong parte dito sa may dito sa baba, okay? So hindi to may stress, oh, pag masyadong baba dito sa may paa natin, baka may stress itong dito sa may ito sa may thigh natin, no? So yung ayun ang arm natin ganyan, no, nakadikit sa katawan, tsaka yung kamay, dapat yung pinakita natin ganina, meron tayong tinatawag na arm and wrist angle. So ganyan, if this is your keyboard, if this is your mouse. Okay, so meron din tayong tinatawag na height, no, keyboard height, na hindi naman masyadong nasa taas yung keyboard, na maano ma-stress to masyadong ma-stress itong mga wrist at saka arm natin, no? Kailangan mayroon tayong height na katulad nito. Okay, so yung monitor height, dapat yung height na level yung sa mata natin yung monitor. Okay, hindi masyadong baba kasi yung masira yung posture natin. Hindi naman masyadong taas kasi yung mga display natin sa operations natin, yung ibang mga display natin nandoon sa taas. So ano mangyayari? So itong batok dito, yung liig dito, it will suffer stresses. So dapat yung display natin i-level lang sa mata. So ayun, dapat yun ang titingnan natin. Tsaka yung viewing distance, no? So sa display tsaka sa operator, dapat readable yung viewing distance natin. Okay. So ibig sabihin, dapat kung gaano kalayo yung readable pa ng operator, 'yun ang gagawin natin. Kasi hindi naman masyadong maganda pag masyadong malapit, kasi of course mayroon yung sa display natin, yung sa computer monitor, mayroon yung mga radiation, no? Mga light radiation that it will affect to the eye of the operator. So hindi naman masyadong malapit, hindi naman masyadong malayo, para of course it is readable to that operator. Tsaka yung mga document na i-encode natin, dapat siguro dikit lang sa, no, sa monitor. Okay, bakit kailangan pa natin na malapit yung source na i-encode natin, halimbawa sa computer at saka yung sa monitor talaga, para hindi naman siguro masyadong yung trabaho niya na palingon-lingon, okay, moving frequently, mag-move siya frequently, no? So kasi halimbawa ang yung karamihan sa atin na yung mga data na i-encode natin sa computer nandoon sa baba. So pag andun tayo, patingin sa baba, patingin sa taas, patingin nyo. So of course may stress yung liig natin. Kaya nga dapat yung original na source ng data na i-encode natin sa computer ay dapat magkatabi lang sila para hindi masyadong ma-minimize yung body movement natin to produce that might result to stresses. Okay? So, tsaka yung sa monitor angle, kailangan yan, no? Kailangan natin is yung level lang po. Okay, so these are some of the suggested positions that of course all these things here, yung upuan, yung computer, monitor, table, kung saan nakalagay yung mga mouse, tsaka yung sa keyboard natin. Ito po yung tinatawag natin na human-machine interfacing. That refers to ergonomics. Okay, that will result to comfortability of the operator. Okay, so yung ipinakita natin dito sa picture na ito, ito lang po yung picture na yung sa computer. Pero kahit hindi sa computer, kahit saan, no? Kahit sa opisina, nagtitrabaho kayo sa opisina, sumusulat, yun, kailangan yung lamisa natin, yung table natin, in a proper position, yung upuan natin, na, yun, na naka-level, all these things should be considered. Okay? And hindi lang doon sa machine, kahit sa, yun, ventilation, illumination, light intensity, and even humidity, kasi pag masyadong ano ba yun, yung maliit yung humidity, it will affect also our performance, no? Our body temperature. Okay, so ito nga po, mayroon tayong mga caricature dito. Ano po sabi ng bata dito, daddy, what's ergonomics? Sabi po dito ng daddy niya, it makes making children tall enough not to have dads bent so much. Yun po yung sabi niya, yung tao dito eh. So, sabi ng ama dito na ergonomics is to think of adjustments. So, ano ang pinakamadali dito sa picture? Itong bata, palakihin natin. Para yung ama hindi masyadong magbibent, yuyuko para lang sa bata, no? So mahirap na mag-alaga ng bata pag nakayuko, kasi of course it will result to stresses and body effect or posture that will affect the body of a person, which is because it is not the normal. Pag nakalakad tayo, dapat naka-straight, no? Good posture so that it will not damage the supports. Ano po ba yung mga supports natin? Yung bone natin, no? So, ito, it will damage yung sa likuran natin, no? So, ano gagawin? So, it makes this boy, this child, to grow so that hindi palagi nakayuko yung ama. Ito po yung tinatawag natin na ergonomics. Okay, so, ganda itong posisyon ng yung pusa natin dito, nakatulog, okay? An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Okay? So, yun po nga pong sabi nila, prevention is better than cure. Ayan po, kasi mahirap yun eh. So, mahirap kahit maliit lang yung prevention natin, malaki na yung effect. Okay, especially if we are now in the situation to cure the damage or the injury. Okay? So malaki yung effect ng ergonomics ng tao, yung masisira yung posture, masisira yung katawan niya, it will result to a chronic injury. So malaki yung effect sa kahit maliit na prevention to our body. Okay? Ano po ba yung sabi ng pusa dito? Oh, I shouldn't have eaten that mouse. Kinain pala yun yung mouse dito, kaya nga nakatulog. So, ano bang mouse? Mouse ng computer siguro yung kinakain niya, kaya nga nakatulog. O di kaya patay na ito. Okay, so it ends our discussion class. It ends ergonomics. Now, take note, class, that this ergonomics that we discuss here is the interfacing between man and machine that will result to chronic injuries to our operators. Okay, so not only operators, any workplaces, kahit sa opisina nyo, kailangan natin ng principles of ergonomics, theory and principles of ergonomics, okay? Science of ergonomics, because it will help to minimize and to limit injuries, chronic injuries of the individuals. Because yun nga po, yung trivia natin, 1/3 of these injuries causes billion of losses in the business and in a company. Okay, so through compensation, pangbayad ng hospital, pangbayad ng mga empleyado natin na nakasakit, pangbayad ng yung sa health insurance nila, ganun. So we should have to consider ergonomics in our workplaces. So thank you very much. So I hope that you learn many things, okay, with regards to safety and health through this principle of ergonomics. So if you learned something, please, of course, again, I will invite you to subscribe my YouTube channel so that, of course, if we have new video that will be uploaded, you will be notified. Click that notification bell and then share this one to you, to anybody that want to learn about ergonomics. Thank you very much. God bless and stay healthy and stay safe.
I like it in mission and vision, instilling excellence in electrical profession, having a dynamic professional association. Rising to any